Thank you for that message and song. According to some experts, there are about three or four things that will help lengthen our lives. Number one, we said diet. Number two, exercise. Number three, medicines. Of course, number four, God's will, you know, He is in control of everything. So here we thank the this is the pharmacy department this afternoon. They are the ones who provide us the medicine, so thank you very much. And this morning it was the dining, you are the ones who provide us the food, so thank you very much. It will lengthen our lives, you know. When the spirit falls, or when the spirit revives, Jeff and Sally were happily married. He didn't have children, but they were happy because they spent time together. Almost their spare moments, they want to be together. They're so happy being together most of the time. One day, Jeff got sick, and it didn't take a long time, he passed away. He was placed in a coffin and brought into the cemetery. And it was a very bad experience for Sally. Sally was devastated. She felt very disappointed. What happened? It seemed that he could no longer eat. He could no longer sleep. He could no longer fix her house and arrange things. And the worst thing is that she was crying most of the time, and because of that, she tried drugs, taking drugs. Things were scattering at home. Until one day, a friend came and met Sally. The friend was very convenient, very cordial, very good, happy. She suggested Sally, she cooked something and let Sally eat. And she said, Sally, I'm in your house. Don't worry, I'm in your house. While she was cleaning the house, arranging things, she was able to discover an envelope. And then she opened the envelope. Inside the envelope was a letter. A letter and a bank book showing a deposit of $87,000. The letter says, Dear, my dear Sally, I know that when I will rest and help you, life will be different. So, I put the difference for Sally because we have a very close, congenial relationship. But I have done everything to provide for your needs, for everyone. Enclosed, you will find a bank book indicating a deposit of $87,000. I have also left a key for a safety deposit box in the bank. When you open the box, you will find other items which I have left for you. I want you to be happy and be provided with all your material needs when I am gone, because I love you. Yeah. So the next day, Sally and her friend went to the bank, and they opened the safety deposit box in the bank. What do you think did they see? Oh, first, they saw cash. $32,000. They saw also some stock certificate amounting to $550,000. They saw Boeing collection amounting to $47,000. They had Jeff has left bank deposit and interest $50,000. Sally didn't know anything about it. And Sally started to smile. And eventually, she was able to laugh, you know. When Jesus ascended to heaven, the disciples' hearts were broken. John 16:5. But he promised the gift of the Holy Spirit to comfort them. Jesus said, I will not leave you. Jesus was telling his disciples to wait in Jerusalem. Just wait in Jerusalem. Because I'm sending you a comforter. Jesus had promised, and is there anything impossible with God? Is there anything? Yes, there is. What's that? What is impossible with God? It is impossible for God to lie. Hebrews 6:18. So, don't promise to Jesus, you again to run on, because it is impossible for him to lie. And she really fulfilled his promise. Desire of ages, taking it divine again, 668-59. But the Spirit, the Savior, will be accessible to all. In this sense, he will be nearer to them than he had not, than if he had not ascended on high. So, when the Holy Spirit was sent by Jesus, he was much more, much nearer to the disciples. You can have Jesus as a third person. The Holy Spirit of the God is dwelling in you. He brings joy in place of our sorrow. Strength in place of our weakness, wisdom in place of our ignorance, the promise of the Spirit gives us hope. And that was what the disciples received when they received the Holy Spirit. It is to your advantage that I go away, Jesus was saying, as he continued. Telling you why the desire of ages, page 669, wrote these words. Compared with humanity, Christ would have been every place personally. Therefore, it was for their interest that he should go to the Father and send the Spirit to be successor on earth. No one could then have any advantage because of his occasion or his personal contact with Christ, because the Holy Spirit can be present everywhere. If the Holy Spirit is present in the Davao, he is also present in the heavenly world. He's there. Everywhere. The Greek word translated power in Acts 1:8 is dunamis. The English word dynamite was derived from it, but the word has a deeper meaning. It also means possibilities from the original language. What are the possibilities? When the Holy Spirit came, new possibilities came to the disciples. The word came to them in Jerusalem. That was Passover time. And people from different parts of the world, known world during the time, the Persians, the Medes, the Elamites, the Mesopotamians, the Egyptians, the Libyans, the Cretans, the Arabs, they went to Jerusalem. And they were there. That's why the Holy Spirit had given them the gift of tongues. And as they were speaking, as Peter was speaking to the assembly, all the people understood what he was saying. And the other disciples talking, they were speaking in different tongues. So the Persians there understood what they were saying. The Medes, the Elamites, etc., they understood because of the gift of the Holy Spirit. What was the result of the outpouring of the Spirit on the day of Pentecost? The glad tidings of the risen Savior were carried to the uttermost part of the inhabited world. And the disciples proclaimed the message of redeeming grace, hearts yielded to the power of the message. Not only that the disciples later on went to different places, but those people who were present during the time in Jerusalem, when they went home, when they went back home, they also, who were converted there, they also gave the message to their fellow men. The church, the head converts flocking to her from all directions. Backsliders were reconverted. Sinners united the believers in seeking the pearl of great price. Some who had been the bitterest opponents of the gospel became its champion. That is also important to remember. come, there are new possibilities that will come to us. When the Holy Spirit comes, there are amazing things, miraculous things that will happen to us. I will give you an assignment when you go home tonight. If you have time, you read Ezekiel 37. And you will see there the story of the dry bones. One day the Lord brought Ezekiel into a valley. And Ezekiel was shown dry bones. Why? Because of the sunlight. Dry because of the sunlight. And then the Lord asked Ezekiel, is it son of man? Can these bones live? And when Ezekiel, what shall I answer? If he asked Isaiah, you can share it and say, only the Lord can declare things from the beginning to the end. If you ask Jeremiah, maybe Jeremiah will say, Lord, you can do all things. But Ezekiel's answer was, oh Lord God, you know. And so the Lord was pleased, and he said to Ezekiel, son of man, prophesy to this bones. What did Ezekiel do? He prophesied to the bones. And after his prophecy, what happened? There was a great noise. There was a shaking. And then the bone connected to another bone. Maybe the, what do you call that? The spine, I don't know what you think, the flexor, I don't know, the science people know all those. But they connected together. And then their own flesh was put there above the bones. And later on the skin ended up. And later on, the Lord told Ezekiel to prophesy again for the wind, for the air, to go inside the nose of the standing bones. And then they stood as a great army. Is it possible that the Spirit of God will come to man and live in today? And inspire them, bring revival, give it a new life and vitality. Is it possible? From the human perspective, it is impossible to bring the bones back to life. But there is nothing too hard for the Lord. God has the word of wonders. The word of God brings to life. A sinner may be dead in sin, but by the power of God, he can be raised into a new life of righteousness. From being children of darkness, he can transform us to children of light. Just as Ezekiel obeyed and acted and God answered in a miraculous way, we will also see God's miraculous manifestation of great revival in our midst if we only submit ourselves to God. When God will give the Holy Spirit in us, in answer to our prayers, we will be doing great things for Him. The Lord said, call to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. Beloved, may the Lord bless us. Let us be praying for revival and reformation. This will miraculously happen to us, and we will be praying.